you very much for joining us. We're excited to have Alexis from Siete Misterios here. They're our featured brand for this month. We've kind of been talking about this for a while, and we're excited that it finally happened. So, Alexis, tell us a little bit about how did you get connected with Siete Misterios?
Well, first of all, thank you so much for having me here. I really, really appreciate it, and giving us the time and featuring us in this beautiful establishment. I'm born and raised in California. My parents immigrated to the U.S. in the 80s. My dad's from Mexico City, my mom's from Jalisco. So I decided to get my dual citizenship and move to Mexico. And while I was in Mexico, I was like, okay, well, I'm here. And I want to push my boundaries, so I want to work at one of the best restaurants in the world. So I worked at Quintonil. And that's where I got familiar with the brand, because they had the Siete Misterios line there. They had some of the clay pot expressions. They had the Dobie in one of the cocktails during that time.
Awesome. That's cool. It sounds like the owners of the brand, Julio and Eduardo Mestre, they had kind of a culinary background too, or at least in restaurants. Some way or spirits?
So, Julio and Eduardo were actually in media before then. They had a firm, like a marketing firm.
Oh, wow.
And they did have like relationships with, soft drinks and beer and alcohol, okay, along with many other things as well. They started going down to Oaxaca around 2004, 2005. It was just exploring Oaxaca. They would go down to Puerto Escondido. They would drive throughout all of Oaxaca. They're always mezcal lovers. But it was funny enough, it was when Eduardo had a flight that he kind of had a moment where he was just like, wait, that you're telling me that this is from the same region or maybe the same camp, but they taste so different from each other. So he just became enamored, and he told his brother Julio, he was just like, man, like, I just had this fantastic experience. And Julio was kind of the one that was just like, all right, well, let's just go for a ride. Let's just like get a rental car, go through every like pueblito, and get sampled the mezcal. They told me that they would get back to Mexico City with like 40, 50 liters of mezcal in their trunk.
Sounds like a party.
Yeah,
that's awesome.
Right? They were like, we couldn't drink it ourselves. I mean, I'd be really impressed if you but they told me like they were just like became enamored with mezcal, the folklore, the history, that and kind of the play on like the name, like it's just so mysterious. We were talking about it earlier, like no matter how much you try to dig into it, something will come up and you realize like, wow, I really don't know much about this actually.
Yep.
So yeah, that's where the love and the mystery started.
That's beautiful. I feel like that's common. That's kind of a common thread for, you know, if you are going down the rabbit hole of mezcal, you do have one of those moments where you're like, wow, this is the same agave made nearby, but they are so different. That's really cool. So you guys, it seems like Santiago, Mazatlán, Sola de Vega, and San Dionisio, Ocotec, those are kind of the main areas that you're sourcing the mezcal from.
Yeah.
Is that right?
That's correct.
That's cool.
Really good. Maybe as well, we have one more, which is in Yautepec.
Okay.
The Olla de Barro line is in Sola de Vega, and the ensemble is from San Dionisio. What I love about our bottles is that there's a nice little cheat sheet at the bottom, especially for people who are just getting into mezcal.
Yeah.
It's really easy for them to pinpoint where it is and have a starting off point as to like, oh, this maybe is what the mezcal tastes like from this area.
And so Olla de Barro is distilled in clay, is that
that's
right?
Correct.
Beautiful. I love the artwork. Who's doing the artwork for you guys?
As I mentioned, it was Julio and Eduardo. So when they started the brand, mezcal was not very popular whatsoever. And they just decided to do everything themselves. They did the Julio was the one who had the idea of doing the day we're in Zoom meetings like a couple of times a week, and we'll say like, oh, what about this, and what about this, and what about this like very creative thing, and you know, he's just brilliant in that sense for sure.
Awesome. The website's really fun too. There's some of the characters on the website. Please check that out. I wanted to ask you about the preservation program that Siete Misterios started. I've been hearing about it, and there's some really cool stuff going on, it sounds like.
Yeah, so the Siete Misterios Agave Preservation Program is in Zona de Vega. It's actually run by Julio and Eduardo's mom. She used to be our rep in Mexico City.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, she got some really fantastic placements there. She taught us in some great off-prem stores as well. Really like Siete Misterios wouldn't be where it is without her. And now she volunteered to run our agave preservation program. It's about 5 acres. We have about 11 different species. Almost no espadi, but the fact that it's the most common.
There's some
of
that.
Yeah, it's the most common. But we have like a little bit of jabalí. Lacio, so it's really fun. It's really fantastic. It's really fun. It's run by her and her her husband, who's funny enough also named Eduardo. I think about 7 dogs as well.
Are you all just taking like the jibuelos and then kind of propagating them, or how does that work? Is it all from seed or?
Seed.
It is from seed. Awesome. We feel really fortunate because initially we were just getting the adobe.
Yeah.
And then Raven brought us some stuff to taste, and it's just kind of like, it feels like Washington and Oregon are kind of a year or two or a step behind California in that stuff. So we're really excited to bring these guys in. Well, the flight, we're going to do, this month's flight will be the Doble, the Olla de Barro Espadín, and the Ensemble. We're going to do that for $24. And after this, we're going to have a staff tasting where Alexis is going to educate a lot of our staff about some of these. So I hope you can come in and try them out. Thanks for joining us today. Thanks, Alexis, for your time and coming and talking Mezcal with us.
Thank you.
Cheers.